Assam Rifles, formed under the British in the year 1835. Since then, has served in a variety of folds, including its participation in World War I and II. The force has come a long way and is the oldest paramilitary as well as the highest decorated security force on a per capita basis in the country. Assam Rifles is the largest paramilitary force of Northeast, and other than conducting kinetic operations, the force has earned the name as Sentinels of Northeast due to their task of supporting the population in the region. The practical, continuous and effective training structure of Assam Rifle helps its soldiers getting prepared to meet the operational requirements of the Northeast region. There have been innumerable cases where Assam Rifles has gone beyond its duty to help the common man. Assam Rifles being deployed in the Northeast states, the complete state of Mizoram is being looked by Sector 23 headquarters, further having 3 units, 1 AR, 46 AR and 10 AR, and this sector has not only gone out of the way to help people of this region on the humanitarian ground but also motivating the local crowd to come and join the organization. The force is doing its duties with complete dedication but has very dedicatedly followed the directions of enlisting the women employment too in Assam Rifles, which was started under Mahila Recruitment since March 2015.
We have set the target for about 30 women this year which we want to recruit into the Assam Rifles or the Army. We know that as far as Northeast is concerned, the girls are at par with the boys, and our aim is to provide them opportunities in terms of job opportunities or from the sports quota what we have for the Assam Rifles.
The Mahila recruits are being effectively deployed equally with their male counterparts, helping to establish a better connect with the female population of the Northeast region. One such recruit is Sophie from Sirchip, who is not just a Mahila recruit but an example of the struggle and the role of Assam Rifles, which has been able to touch the life of the people in the Northeast states. There is more to the story of Sophie than meets the eye. Sophie, actually the sister of Gregory, the resident of a remote town of Sirchip in Mizoram, was recruited as a rifleman in Assam Rifles in the year 2010 and became the breadwinner of the entire family, including his father. Things were falling in place when a tragedy struck the family just after 2 years, and the 23-year-old Gregory met with a very severe accident. By the sincere efforts of doctors, his life was saved, but his lower body got completely paralyzed and the whole family was shattered.
There comes a stage in life when we have to decide that we want to stay to the same page, change the page or write another book. Maybe this is what came into Gregory's mind and his mother's mind when she wrote a letter to DGR Shillong, stating that they were in a bad state and they wanted help.
2011 a 19 samai phala kaluta 2012 a live kalin gawati tangin kan kholam serchi panin kan honalama silonga accident ka toka chuan spine injury kanaya C7 ka taksa ache theilawa damdoina koma utlen hospitala kumkhat koma chuan 2014 a disability pension in ka chuwa damdoi chirang rang engkim min tum sakwa ka ka pension nu apo in check up bun pon Mizoram atanga silong thleng ambulance afrin in kal sakwa zela
tuya kan pa accident an to ta ka chuan reason na mul mal kan nei la ka kan nu in samrai phila tangle turin anaute application as we are to the belong after calling the end of the boss in the tuna healing analysis.
Colonel Vijendra Singh, when he came here, he saw that the mother was wanting to join the organization. But strange are the ways of life as well as its surprises. He said it is not possible for her to join, but he wanted the daughter to join.
Kan papa bi ko ribana kina accident ho komde chung hianin sipai me chi an tang a ti kan sia lo pa ni har su taken kan ang papa ai den cha ko kan su lo ni ma se la komi huwa me chi a sipai an la be ti kan sia ta pa pa ni dien da form ke sia kin di ji a ra si lo ha kan ke lu be ta pa chu kan el na ko ki chu ICR is ye 10AR a te kan pe a tin 10AR Cornel, Vijendra Singh, Hian, Nasakan Mang Lapia, and in Aki local in the Aou, Nibor, Nibana, Supaya, and Petolo, Bani, and now Sophie Banan Mai, Supaya Chang, Pedula, Man, and Lastapa, Una Hian, Supaya Chang, a training mechanic.
Mira Nam Sophie Valent Mangai, who may egg Mahila recruit who may Mizoram Sierchip K, Rene Wali, who may Gregory Ki Behen, who मेरे भाई एक्सीडेंट के बाद 10ARCO ने मुझे भर्ती होने की सजेशन दिया और साथ ही मुझे प्री ट्रेनिंग का हिस्सा बनाया इस प्री ट्रेनिंग से मुझे फिजिकल टेस्ट रिटन टेस्ट के लिए मुझे मदद हुए आज मैं यहां असम राइफल ट्रेनिंग सेंटर एंड स्कूल सुखोवी लुसाई कंपनी नंबर 6 प्लाटून में ट्रेनिंग कर रही हूं मुझे मेरे सीनियर ने मुझे बहुत सपोर्ट किया है और मैं कर्नल Brijendra Singh, 10ARCO, DIG 23 Sector, Brigadier MS Mukha Sena Medal. IGAR is Major General Upendra Dwedika, specially thanks karti hu.
As for the local population is concerned, firstly we have identified that who will have the maximum reach to the local population. These are your NGOs, what we have, the civil administration, the school teachers. So that's why we are focusing on them. Also, there are so many central government schemes like Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. These schemes are also we are looking at in a big way, and we are making sure that the such schemes the locals are made aware of.
Sophie's story is one story which proves the role of Assam Rifles both as a facilitator and the end mean.
The effort to help Sophie and her family just didn't end on the idea. But it was implemented, and implemented in a commendable manner, where Colonel Brijendra Singh of 10AR was inspired very much to start with a pre-recruitment camp for the youngsters, boys and girls of District Sirchip. Colonel Brijendra Singh in this venture of his was very well supported by his senior, the commander of headquarters, 23 Sector, Brigadier MS Mokha Sena Medal. The support from these higher authorities led Sophie to get selected in Assam Rifles. So this incident inspired you so much that you ended up starting with a camp for the pre-recruitment training of the boys and girls, you know, to get trained in this camp to get selected in Assam Rifles. So what motivated you to do that?
See, within Assam Rifles, our role, our job, what we do is limited not only to, you know, fighting insurgency or fighting the militants or guarding the border. You know, we are part and parcel of the social life of the people here. Mm-hmm. You know, it is, we over the years, we have been here for ages. And we ensure that we train people here, we empower people here. The more the isolated the places, and the company Northeast would agree with me that most of the places are really isolated.
Absolutely.
The more is the involvement of Assam Rifle life.
So what exactly do you do in this pre-recruitment training camp? Are you restricted to some key contents of it? What does it comprise of?
See, the final recruitment is a very fair and transparent process which is done by the Staff Selection Commission and the Army's the recruitment office. That's a very fair and transparent. So what we do, most of the people of these areas, what happened that the people are not aware of the right documentation procedures. So most of the applicants are rejecting the document itself, that they have not put their domicile certificate, the education certificate. Second is, you know, the physical tests that are involved.
Okay.
You know, so we kind of tell them, see, you have to run this much kilometer,
you to do this much of physical exercise over there. So try to induce them, telling them, yes, okay, this is where they have to be.
Now, one of the most important questions that I want to ask you, that Mizoram is, like you said, in a very isolated area. And of course, the remote areas like Sirchip again are even more isolated. And here, people or the children are not guided correctly. So what, I mean correctly in the sense that because they are into remote areas, they are into the different awareness sections of life, the awareness level is very low. So how, first of all, how do you motivate them? Like you said that you do it through camps and you know, training sessions. But how do you motivate them to come and join your training sessions?
We interact with them. We have the schools and colleges which are there.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes we go and do a lecture for them how to join
Army,
how to join Assam Rifles.
Okay.
Whatever role is what we do.
Okay.
We have the introduction to the weapons to them sometime 15th August, 26th January.
How well has the local crowd of Mizoram taken the female entry, the Mahila recruitment?
Differentiation of the society, the male and female is not there. The equality in the society as far as the men and women are concerned is very high.
It's very high, that's for sure.
It is a very welcome measure for them that they realize that yes, you know, Assam Rifle Army also
is welcoming us
and accept this thing.
How have your seniors supported you in this entire venture, and how do they support all of you, all you officers, to go in and do ventures like this or go and do programs like this?
This the whole course of reaching out to people and getting them into the recruitment pre-training is a brainchild of our commander Brigadier Mokha.
Mm-hmm.
And our IG General Upendra Dwivedi.
As leaders, we take the ownership of any recruit who is joining the security forces. As you are aware that we have standard operating procedures for any soldier who is joining for his safety and providing the congenial environment. We are also ensuring that the Vishakha guidelines which have been given out are being followed into. Also, the commanding officers are carrying out regular interaction, and the women officers which are there are having the WhatsApp group with all the female soldiers, and we are making sure that there is a regular interaction by them regularly.
But in spite of the fact that Assam Rifles is deployed in the northeast region of the country, their Mahila recruitment is not just restricted to the area but is open to the entire country.
असम राइफल में ट्रेनिंग के टाइम मुझे अपने देश के बारे में एक्सपोजर मिला और पता लगा कि इसी सारे देश वासी एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में साथ काम करते हैं. यहाँ और भी स्टेट की महिला रिक्रूट है और उनसे बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिलता है.
No nation can be worthy of its existence without the women of the nation moving hand in hand with the men. No country can be successful in a struggle before the women come and participate in the struggle. This has been proven by the history over a period of years, especially in India. Assam Rifles has not only understood and realized it, but even motivated the women to come and join the organization, proving these words correct. They have not only helped them getting bharti, but also helped them getting motivated, getting encouraged, getting inspired by the organization on the whole, where the men, where the ustads, where the senior officers have been of great help to these women to come up in the best manner. All these wonderful women who are strong, who are capable and have dreamt of being in combat at some point of time in their life are doing well for themselves, and it is a dream come true which the Assam Rifles has done for them.
तो मेरे भाई की मदद से मैंने इस फॉर्म को फिलअप करके इसमें भर्ती हुआ, और मेरे पति और मेरे सास ससुर की मदद से, उनके सपोर्ट से मैं असम राइफल में ज्वाइन हो पाई.
मुझे असम राइफल के बारे में पहले जानकारी नहीं थी. मुझे वर्दी से बहुत लगाव था और मुझे वर्दी चाहिए थी, इसलिए मैं भर्ती हुई, मेरा सिलेक्शन हुआ. और यहाँ आने के बाद में मुझे असम राइफल में बहुत प्राउड फील हुआ. यहाँ के अफसर्स, JCOs एंड हमारे जो गुरुजी पार्टी थे, वस्ताद थे, उन्होंने हमें बहुत सपोर्ट किया. लेडीज़ ऑफिसर्स सभी ने हमें बहुत सपोर्ट किया.
मैं ARTC में आ गया ट्रेनिंग सेंटर में, तो कुछ उधर में तो कुछ पता नहीं था. उधर में सब गुरुजी लोग, साहब लोग, सब हमको सपोर्ट दिया. सब हमने क्या वो नहीं होता उनको हमको सिखाया, इसलिए हमको सब कुछ सीख के इधर आ गया. हम लोग
फौज में आने के बाद बहुत प्राउड कर रही हूँ कि मैं कुछ देश के लिए कर सकती हूँ, कि लड़कियां कहीं से कम नहीं है, खुद के सेवा भी, खुद का सेफ्टी भी कर सकते हैं और देश का भी सेवा कर सकते हैं।
मैं देश के लिए कुछ करना चाहती थी, असम राइफल के थ्रू ये अपॉर्चुनिटी मुझे मिली और यहाँ आकर एक वुमेन को एक सोल्जर के रूप में प्रूफ करने का मुझे एक मौका मिला। यहाँ के ऑर्गेनाइज ने मुझे और ऑफिसर्स ने हम लोगों को बहुत सपोर्ट किया, जिसके थ्रू आज हम ट्रेंड सोल्जर बन चुके हैं। हमारा मोटो यही है, वी कैन बी चाहिए।
मैडम मेरे को टाइम हो गया, कम से कम 3-4 महीने हो गए।
जी मैम, आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे अपनी ये महिला स्टूडेंट्स के बारे में?
मैं तो ये कहना चाहूँगा मैम कि आजकल के युग में लड़कियाँ जो है बहुत लड़कों से काफ़ी आगे हैं। मैंने अदर फॉर्मेशन में देखा लेडीज़ जो है, जैसे CRPF हो गया, SIB हो गया, उसमें लड़कियाँ जो है सोल्जर, एज ए सोल्जर बन करके अपनी ड्यूटी कर रही हैं। तो हमारे असम रिफल्स के अंदर फर्स्ट बैच आया, जो महिला बैच आया, उनको हमने देखा कि ये जो है और फॉर्मेशन की अपेक्षा हमारी जो फॉर्मेशन में जो लड़कियां जो ट्रेंड के ट्रेनिंग किया हम दिया इनको, ये बहुत ही ऊंचे दर्जे की ट्रेनिंग दी।
अ वुमन हु गार्ड्स एंड प्रोटेक्ट्स द एंटायर फैमिली कैन गार्ड द कंट्री बॉर्डर टू, एंड शी इज टफ इनफ टू ओवरकम द ऑब्स्टिकल्स इन डूइंग सो। महिला रिक्रूटमेंट इन असम राइफल्स सब्सटेंशिएट्स द फैक्ट द ट्रेनिंग ऑफ महिला रिक्रूट्स इज कंडक्टेड at ARTC at Sukhovi in exclusive training areas. But like every student requires the correct mentorship and guidance. This other than the instructors come from the lady officers around them too. Any bold step taken by a human being is a blend of competence and fear. As we've seen, the Mahila GDs in Assam Rifle are very competent, but at the same time, they undergo some fears at times because they come from different backgrounds and they have their apprehensions to face with. In that, the role is played by the seniors, be it the officers, the ustads. We've already spoken to some ustads, but we have with us Major Monica today, a senior lady officer posted at Assam Rifle. She's been in the organization since last 9 years and she very well knows how to motivate these Mahila GDs.
The induction of women as Mahila GD soldiers in Assam Rifle is a historic moment, and the maiden initiative of recruiting these women as Mahila GDs, as soldiers in Assam Rifle, is a noble endeavor towards women empowerment. All the officers from this sector, they are there to motivate these Mahila GD soldiers, and of course the force behind of all of us is our commander, Brigadier MS Mocha Sena Middle. These women soldiers, they perceive combat forces as a potentially transformative realm that holds promise for a better life and opportunity, which basically make them overcome the limitations which they have in the domain as a woman in civil society.
As a woman, you have certain, you know, blues and certain apprehensions. So do you have any recreational activities? Do you do something special other than the training to motivate them?
Definitely we have. We keep on interacting with them regularly. The Assam Rifles have given a wonderful platform to the Mahila GD soldiers who have not been exposed to the world. Most of the Mahila GD soldiers here in Assam Rifles, they have been, you know, they are excelling in sports and games.
Keeping the symbolism and the association with Mizoram, we have with us Captain Baby Lal Dusang. She is been serving in Assam Rifles for last 1 year and is a local resident of Aizawl. She is a motivation for the localites here.
In Mizo society, women has equal rights and freedom as men. Mizo women are physically strong and do all kinds of professional work. However, there are very few women who are keen and are motivated in joining the armed forces. Since I was a kid, I was interested in combat. And when we were in college, the Assam Rifle officers would often come to our college and motivate us in joining the armed forces. And they also helped us a long way in clearing the interviews, the written interviews. So it was the Assam Rifle, in fact, that actually helped me in joining the army.
And you as a role model, how do you do that for the localites here in Mizoram?
Our sector commander, Brigadier MS Mocha, SM, is very keen in motivating the Mizo women, Mizo youth and students in joining the armed forces. So he gave me an opportunity to go to colleges, to go to school, to go to youth function, and even to church services, where I can motivate, I can share my experiences in joining the armed forces to the women, to the youth and to the students.
I must say, that the society and population both are urged to make sure that maximum female population from Northeast is provided this employment opportunities. As you are aware that in security forces today, the women are being treated equally in all spheres, whether it's sports, operations, training, or even adventure activities. I am sure in days to come, we'll be having more number of female soldiers joining the forces.
Here's to the strong women of our country. Let us know them, let us raise them. Everybody needs an opportunity and a platform to grow in life. Assam Rifle has given this opportunity to these lovely and wonderful Mahila GDs. They are mothers, they are cooks, they are daughters, they are wives, but they are the strongest creation of God, and they have realized that strength in themselves as well as Assam Rifles as an organization. Woman is like a tea bag who only understands the potential of herself, and even the world understands her potential after it is put into the hot water. So is the women of India. Assam Rifle, hats off to the step it has taken to actually come up with the term women empowerment.